your findings on behalf of Shannon.
Thank you very much. We thank the members of this committee for your invitation to make this presentation. As your Octus legislators, you have a vital role in ensuring public service oversight and accountability. While no one has been killed or tortured in Shannon, insofar as we know, hundreds of thousands have been killed in Middle Eastern wars and thousands tortured, and successive Irish governments have been complicit in these crimes. An Iraqi child killed by US air attack or an Afghan resistance fighter tortured at Bagram Air Base are just as important as an Irish child or an Irish soldier. The thousands of Afghan and Iraqi dead children are just as important as the 796 children buried in Tuam. Gordy and Shannon, at the apparent behest of the Irish government, have consistently refused to investigate these issues. Let me introduce our team. We are a group of peace activists trying to ensure compliance with Irish and international laws. I am a former Army officer and former United Nations military peacekeeper. I lecture part-time on politics and international relations at the University of Limerick. And as a civilian, I've been promoting democracy and the rule of law in post-conflict countries in Africa, Asia, the Middle East, the Balkans and the former Soviet Union. Margaret Darcy is a committed peace activist and member of AS Donna. She's a founding member of the Greenham Common Women's Peace Camp in the 1970s, protesting against Pershing cruise missiles. Some of you may know that these cruise missiles at the time were armed with nuclear warheads. In the meantime, the nuclear warheads have been replaced by what they call sub-nuclear warheads. Coincidentally, we are now aware that in June 1999, two plane loads of these cruise missiles passed through Ireland, probably through Shannon Airport. At the time, cruise missiles were being used to bomb the embassy, the Chinese embassy in Belgrade, and the television station. Margaret is a writer and dramatist, and she uses dramatic actions to expose what's going on at Shannon Airport. Dr. John Lennon is a human rights activist of long standing with Amnesty International and other NGOs. He's a full-time lecturer at the Kemi Business School at the University of Limerick and is a founder and member of Shannon Watch and has produced this booklet on the legal aspects of what's happening at Shannon Airport. Today we want to present to you what's happening at Shannon and the significance of these events, in the expectation that you will take appropriate actions to investigate and achieve some accountability for what has transpired. The details of our presentation are contained in our written submission, which you already have. So our verbal submission will just highlight the key issues. I will focus on neutrality. Margaret will look at the failures to inspect or investigate what's been happening at Shannon Airport, and on the probability that Ireland has facilitated operations by US Special Forces, including the US drone programme. Dr. John Lennon will explain the scale and scope of the US torture rendition programme and the extent to which successive Irish governments have been directly complicit in this programme in contravention of the UN Convention Against Torture and our own Irish Criminal Justice UNCAT Act 2000. He will also sum up our presentation and outline what recommendations we would like you, the committee, to undertake. Dealing with neutrality, neutrality is not just a piece of legal terminology. For small states such as Ireland, it's an important concept of international law that enables us to avoid being dragged into unjustified wars and also to promote genuine altruistic foreign policies that promote international peace. The broadest definition of neutrality comes from international law experts Oppenheim and Laupack, who state that any state that is not a belligerent in a war is considered to be a neutral state and is therefore bound by international laws on neutrality. Some states declare themselves to be neutral either by writing it into their constitutions or having neutrality as their declared policy. United States was a neutral state for the initial stages of both World War I and World War II. Switzerland, Austria and Finland had neutrality written into their constitutions, and Sweden, Malta and Ireland had neutrality as their declared national policy. All Irish governments have pursued a policy of neutrality since 1939, and this has been strongly supported by the Irish people, as was demonstrated in 2013 in a Peace Neutrality Alliance commissioned Red Sea poll, which found that 78% of the Irish people believe that Ireland should have a policy of neutrality. There are several misconceptions on the rules of neutrality. Ireland sending weather forecasts to England during World War II was not in fact a breach of Irish neutrality. However, one of the most basic rules from Ireland's point of view is Article 2 of the Hague Convention on Neutrality, which states belligerents are forbidden to move troops or convoys of either munitions of war or supplies across the territory of a neutral power. Therefore, a country like the United States at war in Afghanistan and Iraq is not supposed to move troops through Ireland. A clear example of the failure of Irish legislators to curtail the abuse of authority by the Irish government occurred on the 20th of March 2003, when Dail Éireann approved the government motion that in effect claimed to state that the US military use of Shannon Airport did not amount to participation in the US invasion of Iraq. The motion stated as follows: Dail Éireann endorses the decision of the Irish government that Ireland would not participate in the coalition's proposed military action against Iraq. But then goes on to say, Dail Éireann recalls the long-standing arrangements for overflight and landing in Ireland of US military and civilian aircraft and supports the decision of the government to maintain those arrangements. These statements are incompatible and they are an attempt to say that black is white, to say that participation is not participation. This was clearly identified by Judge Nicholas Cairns in the High Court case, Horgan versus Ireland, in April 2003, just a month after this Dail motion was passed, when Judge Cairns ruled, the court is prepared to hold, therefore, that there is an identified rule of customary international law in relation to the status of neutrality, whereunder a neutral state may not permit the movement of large numbers of troops or munitions of one belligerent state to its territory en route to a theatre of war with another. In the Horgan versus Ireland case, I was that soldier. This Oireachtas Committee, in your role as legislators, have a very important role in ensuring that Irish government complies with the basic rules of international law. Just in case some of you might not be aware, it's not just a few dozen troops that pass Shannon Airport. 2.5 million armed US troops, huge amounts of munitions, and other stuff have passed Shannon Airport since 2001. There are very grave matters of human rights involved in Ireland participating in unjustified wars and being complicit in breaches of the UN Convention Against Torture. There are also positive things we should be doing in matters of international relations that have been neglected or damaged by our participation and complicity in wars. Ireland's very beneficial role and our credibility in promoting international peace and justice is being severely damaged. In the long term, it's important that neutrality should be written into the Irish Constitution. In the short term, steps should be taken by this committee and Dail Éireann to end the Irish government's abuses of international and Irish laws, and this should entail immediately ending US military use of Shannon Airport. If there is some legal technicality whereby the Gardaí cannot search US military aircraft, then no US military aircraft should be allowed to land at Irish airports. As we meet here today, civil war is spreading across Iraq. The roots of this civil war were sown on the 20th March 2003 with the US-led invasion of Iraq, just as Dail Éireann legislators were passing a motion that Irish participation in this Iraq war was not participation. John Lennon will explain some problems we have encountered with the Attorney General's office with regard to Gardaí failing to search and investigate US military aircraft at Shannon Airport. We have also experienced some difficulty in recent times with the Garda Ombudsman Commission, who have failed to properly investigate virtually all the complaints made by peace activists to the Ombudsman's office about Garda misbehaviour at Shannon Airport. In recent weeks also, we have encountered indications that the Director of Public Prosecution's office may have been failing in their duty to act independently in matters relating to the prosecution of peace activists at Shannon Airport. All these are serious matters that this committee should examine. I now hand over to Margaret D'Arcy,